Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 13. And we are at the distalmost portion regarding the muscles of the upper limb. And so we are focusing on those intrinsic muscles of the hand. And again, there are certainly more muscles than what we are going to be discussing here or identifying, but we just want to get some of the big picture ideas. So we are looking at a palmar view or an anterior view of the hand. This is going to be lateral. This will be medial because that first digit is always lateral, with the fifth digit always medial when in anatomical position. So the thenar compartment of the hand, or the thenar muscles, are going to be these intrinsic muscles that both have their proximal and distal attachments within the hand. These are going to be the thenar muscles associated with the first digit. And so these muscles, there's three separate muscles in this region. They will flex, abduct, the first digit, as well as play a role in terms of opposition. And you will have a similar set associated with the fifth digit, and these are the hypothenar muscles of the hand. Again, there are three, and they will also flex, abduct, and oppose in terms of the fifth digit. Now, looking at a deeper dissection, so you can see some of those hypothenar muscles right here. We're getting down into the deeper muscles of the thenar compartment here. Right here, you can see where the carpal tunnel has been opened in this region. So you can see some of those tendons. Specifically, these are the tendons of flexor digitorum profundus. And you can see these kind of worm-like muscles that are going to have their proximal attachment on the tendons of flexor digitorum profundus. So unique in terms of where their proximal attachments are. You can see there are going to be four of these. That's a weird looking two, sorry. Three and four. So these are going to be the lumbrical muscles. And then in order to see the interossei muscles, or the palmar interossei muscles, you have to reflect these out of the way and truly get to the bone in order to see these, as the name would suggest. So it's kind of between the bones. And so, and we're only going to look at the palmar interossei and have you identify those, because we don't have a very good image of the dorsal interossei, but of course we know there are dorsal interossei. But you can see the three palmar interossei here. You're going to have them associated with the second, fourth, and fifth digits. So there'll be one, two, three of these. And recall that palmar interossei will play a role in a few actions associated with the hand, but also they will adduct the digits. So bring those digits back towards the third digit, which is kind of the plane by which abduction and adduction occurs. So if you are down to the bone and you see muscles, and they're very similar in terms of shape as the lumbricals, but recall lumbricals are going to be associated with the tendons here of the flexor digitorum profundus, whereas the interossei are going to be almost directly on the bone, and you would have to be at an extremely deep dissection to be able to see these. Okay, excellent. So that should wrap us up in terms of stations focused on the upper limb. We are going to move now to the lower limb with our next station. So I will meet you there. In the meantime, if you have any specific questions regarding identifying the structures here, please feel free to reach out to me with any questions. Thanks for your time.